I welcome you all in this lecture related with the subject Engineering Economics. Now we are going to learn the fourth unit. The name of the fourth unit is Replacement and Maintenance Analysis. First of all, we should know the importance of maintenance in any equipment, because in today's world, almost all of them are using some kind of equipments to fulfill their needs. For example, in residential purpose, we use mixer, grinders, motors to fulfill their residential needs. In the same way, in the manufacturing industry, manufacturers are using some kind of machines to convert their raw material into finished product. For example, in this picture, I have shown the injection molding machine. With the help of this injection molding machine, we can able to produce this kind of plastic components. The quality of this plastic components mainly depends on the machines. If the machines working properly, then we will get the better quality product. So to ensure the perfect functioning of this machine, we have to maintain the machine properly. Otherwise, we will not get the better quality product. And one more thing is, if we are purchasing a new machine, means, for example, a new two-wheeler. One person is purchasing a new two-wheeler. With the help of this new two-wheeler, he is traveling from one place to another place. At the initial stage of this two-wheeler, it will give better mileage, and also the maintenance cost will be very much less over the period of time. For example, after 5 years. After 5 years, the mileage what we are getting in the two-wheeler gets reduced. And one more thing is, the service maintenance cost also increased. So over the period of time, the mechanical components gets worn out due to friction. Friction is mainly due to the relative motion between them. So we have to maintain the mechanical parts properly, then only we will get the better performance with least cost. This, the competition among the companies in the industrial sector is huge. If the company wants to be successful, they have to take the decision properly. In the equipment aspect, the company has to take any one of the following decision. The first decision is to replace the old machine. The second decision is to retain the old machine by doing some maintenance. We know that maintenance costs some amount. In all the industries, each and every equipment has to be replaced after some years of service. The reason for this replacement is either physical damage or obsolescence. The meaning of physical damage is change in physical condition of the machine. That means at the initial stage, the machine works perfectly because the dimension of the components present in the machine is in exact condition. After some years of service, due to the relative motion between the parts, friction may occur. Due to that friction, some part of the component gets worn out. This leads to change in physical condition. This will affect the performance of the machine. Simultaneously, it leads to increases the operational and maintenance cost. The second reason for replacement is obsolescence. Obsolescence means the technology is out of date. In earlier days, we use conventional lathe and conventional milling machine to convert the raw material into finished part. At that time, for turning we use lathe, for milling we use milling machine, for drilling we use a separate drilling machine. But nowadays machining centers are developed. In the machining center, we can do milling operation as well as drilling operation. At present, we use only one machining center to do milling as well as drilling. In earlier days, this is not possible. So due to the out of date technology, we have to replace the old machine. Sometimes our company facilities can't able to meet the required demand. At that time, we can achieve the demand by implementing any one of the following steps. The first step is replacement of the existing equipment with the new one. The second step is augmenting the existing one with the additional equipment. That means already we have one machines. We are adding one more machine to the existing setup, that is augmenting the existing one with additional equipment. We will see the different types of maintenance that are followed in the industries. First one is preventive maintenance, second one is breakdown maintenance. Preventive maintenance is also called as proactive approach. In proactive approach, we are doing maintenance services before the machine reaches the breakdown state. In this approach, we are doing some periodical inspection. At the end of this inspection, we will find some faults in the machine. The next minute, we will fine-tuning this fault. By the way, we are eliminating the major problem in the machine. This kind of maintenance, preventive maintenance, will be done while the machine will be in operating condition. So there is no downtime cost present in the preventive maintenance. But in breakdown maintenance, it is also called as reactive approach. In this approach, we are doing maintenance work once the machine reaches the down state, that is breakdown state. In this breakdown state, there is no processing present in the machine. So automatically we are losing the profit generation. At the same way, for doing maintenance, we are invest some amount. So there is no profit. At the same time, it involves high maintenance cost. So breakdown maintenance leads to more drawback in the industries. Next, we will see the different types of maintenance cost associated in the maintenance program. From this graph, you see that this y-axis represents cost, x-axis represents the optimum level of maintenance. First, look at the preventive maintenance. At the initial stage, if the maintenance level is low, means the preventive maintenance cost will be less. If we are increasing the level of maintenance into higher order, then the preventive maintenance cost will be high. Look at the breakdown cost. At low level, the chance of breakdown occur will be high. So the breakdown cost will be high. If we are increasing the level of maintenance into higher order, then the chance of breakdown get eliminated or reduced. So the breakdown cost involved in the maintenance will be reduced. If you are adding this preventive maintenance cost as well as breakdown maintenance cost, you will find the total maintenance cost. Look at this purple color line. The total maintenance cost will be high in low level maintenance. If you are increasing the level of maintenance to some extent, the total maintenance cost get reduced. After some point, the total maintenance cost gets increased. Note the particular point. From this point, the decreasing manner get converted into increasing manner. That particular point represents the optimum amount of preventive maintenance. Corresponding to this point, you have to note the x-axis value. This x-axis value represents the optimum level of maintenance. If you are maintaining this level, then you will get the better least maintenance cost. If you are crossing this level, then you have to spend more money for maintaining the particular equipment. That leads to some drawbacks in the economic aspect in the industries. Next, we will see the different types of replacement problem that occurs in the industries. In industries, we use two types of components. One is mechanical component, another one is electronical component. Mechanical, we can predict the mechanical component failure because mechanical components are failure in a gradual manner. In mechanical components, the failures occurs mainly due to wear and tear present in the machines. So we can easily evaluate this failure point. But in electronic equipment, the failures are takes place in a sudden manner. So we can't able to predict the failure state, failure time. We can't able to predict the failure time. So in this unit, we are going to learn three concepts. The first concept is determination of economic life of an asset. Asset represents the equipment. Each and every equipment will provide or will generate some profit to the industries. At the initial lifetime, it will generate more profit. After some years, the profit generation gets reduced. After some more years, the maintenance cost of the particular machine is high, so it will not generate profit. It leads to high maintenance costs, so we can't able to generate the profit with the help of that machine. So up to some years, it will generate more cost or more profit to the industry. That is called as economic life. We can find the economic life of a particular machine by using some numerical problems. In this unit, we will find the economic life of a particular machine. The second one is, after once you find the economic life, we have to replace the existing machine with the new machine. If you are going for the new machine, that new machine costs some amount. It also consists of some maintenance. So we have to compare the old machine with the new machine. If our old machine costs some amount and also it involves some maintenance cost. In the same way, new machines also cost some amount. It also includes some maintenance cost. We have to compare these two machines. which is to be more profitable to the industry. That can be done, that can be calculated with the help of this replacement of the existing asset with new asset problem. This problem is also called as challenger defender concept. In the third method, the name of the third method is simple probabilistic model for assets which fail completely. That is for electronic items. In industry, nowadays in industry we are using the electronic equipments in a higher order. So we have to predict the failures of electronic equipments, then only we can replace the electronic equipments in a proper time. Then we will continue the production without any interruption. This graph represents the economic life of a particular machine. As I said, in this unit, first we are doing some numerical problem. This numerical problem is used to find the economic life of an asset. Economic life means up to this point, the machine will earn more profit to the industry. Up to this point, x-axis represents life of the machine, y-axis represents cost. Initially we are purchasing one machine, that machine costs some amount, that represents fixed cost. So it is fixed throughout the life. Suppose if you are purchasing the machine at the cost of 10 lakhs, means throughout this life the first cost of the machine will be 10 lakhs. So we are mentioning the horizontal line. Next, look at the green line. At the initial stage of the life of the machine, the maintenance cost will be low. Once the year progress, the maintenance will be increased. So it leads to high maintenance cost. If you are adding the fixed cost plus operating and maintenance cost, you will get the total cost, that blue color line. If you look at the total cost at the initial lifetime, the total cost will be high. Once the year progress, the total cost of the machine will be reduced up to some extent. After some point, it will start to increasing. You have to note down the conversion point. From low to high, the conversion takes place at one particular point. Corresponding to that point, you have to find the year. This year represents the economic life of an asset. From starting to this year, the equipment will produce more profit to the industry. So that from this statement you can understand that you have to use the machine from this year to this year. After the economic life, the machine will not produce more profit, it will incur more maintenance cost, so it will not advantageous to the industry. So we have to replace the machine after the economic life of an asset. This capital recovery means in the second unit, we already learned that the selling price of a particular product will be found out by including the capital cost of the machine. So at the end of the life, we have to replace the old machine with a new machine. So we need some amount of money. So we have to generate that money by selling the product produced by the machine. At the initial stage of the initial life of the machine will generate more profit. So we will recover more amount of money. Once the year progress, the performance of the machine gets reduced. So we will not be able to recover more money from that machine. That is why the capital recovery line will initially it will be in high position. After some years, it will get reduced.